time is this?
Great. I'm like 2 months behind schedule. Hi folks, I'm Adam, and this is my latest creation in Minecraft. It's the TARDIS from the incredibly popular TV show Doctor Who. Now, we all know that the TARDIS has two major functions, the first being time travel. Honestly, not too interested in that one, seems like a bit of a hassle really. Doctor does it all the time and people are constantly trying to kill him for it. Nope, I'm in this for the second reason, convenient storage space. Whilst the TARDIS isn't exactly the biggest of structures from the outside, turns out that it's somehow far bigger on the inside. If we head inside, we can get a feel for the size of the console room. Pretty large, definitely larger than it looked from the outside. But if we head back out, we can wander around the outside of the police box and see that the console room is nowhere to be seen. Now, this isn't the first time I've played with impossible space in Minecraft. About this time last year, I put up a video on a non-Euclidean corridor layout, which seemed to overlap itself. To do this, I had to use a whole bunch of spawners and spawner minecarts, which spawned falling sand that could form new blocks when you weren't looking. It was all a big hassle. Fortunately, in the year that's passed, we've seen a whole bunch of improvements in Minecraft. For starters, the teleport function has been improved, allowing you to keep your momentum and preventing a flickering visual effect you used to get. So, if I wanted to, I could replace this entire old project with little more than one or two blocks. However, there's a bit more to this project, and the teleport function just wasn't going to cut it. So, I turned to the new clone command. This allows for copy-pasting large areas of blocks from point A to point B. Using this in conjunction with commands that test to see where you're standing, I came up with the idea to have parts of the control room appear and disappear, depending on where you were. So, if we step away from the TARDIS, you can see me leave the control room, and as I do, you'll notice that two small parts of it vanish. From where I was standing, you couldn't see it disappear, and if I were to head back in, those parts would reappear before I even knew they were gone. As I head around the outside, more and more parts of the control room disappear. This was done by cloning a large area of the original mountain into its place. If we take a quick look at this temporary layout I was using when building this, you'll see whereabouts I have the trigger zones. By the time you're at one of the corners, the entirety of the control room has been removed. So, as I head round the corner, I've seen nothing change, creating the illusion that the police box really is bigger on the inside. One thing to note as we wander around the back is the police call box banner. This isn't made from blocks, this is made from entities, just like players, items, and animals. Which means that when I clone the blocks, this doesn't come with, and likewise doesn't disappear. So to spawn this in, I had to check to see what blocks behind it using a command called test for block. If it's a blue clay block, the banner appears, but if it's not, it gets deleted using a kill item command. As we come all the way around, we'll see that the room begins to form again, always out of sight of the player. And so, as we begin to walk back inside, the control room is finally pieced back together, and the player's none the wiser. As you can see, the player can wander back and forth around the structure, and segments of the console room will continue to spawn and despawn to keep that illusion of impossible space. If we head over to the spawn area of the map, we can get a better idea of just how the scenery change is kept from the player. For starters, let's have a look at these clone segments. The clone function only deals in cuboids, so to make sure that the control room is never seen from the outside, and the outside's never seen through the open door, I had to shape a lot of sections to be partially outdoors and partially control room. For the most part, each segment has an on and off state. For instance, here's part of the console room, and here's the same part when viewed from outside. To make the correct switch, I had to use a bunch of the game's inbuilt scoreboards. Let's take another look at some of the markers I built myself, specifically the light and dark green walls, which were used to delete the left-hand side of the console room. Let's say that starting from the doorway, I head left and walk over this line of dark green wall. This will firstly switch out the part of the console room with its outdoor segment, provided I've got a score of 0 on its specific scoreboard. It will then switch my score to 1 so it doesn't try to switch it again. Now, if I head back over the parallel light green line, or if I head all the way around the TARDIS and cross the other light green line, it will check for a score of 1, and if it finds it, it will replace the left-hand part of the console room and try and switch my score to 0. There's 6 scoreboards in total controlling which segments are removed at what time. One for the front sections, one for this left-hand side as I just explained, another for the right-hand side, and 3 for the central part of the back. One for when I approach from the left, one for when I approach from the right, and one for replacing the doorway of the console room with the back wall of the police box. So, that pretty much covers the basics of how to build yourself a TARDIS in Minecraft. I've always been fascinated by the idea of impossible space, especially with regards to video games, because there's so many possibilities for interesting gameplay mechanics. Hopefully I've shown that Minecraft's given itself some huge potential in that regard. There's some great maps out there, such as Jesper's Code 3, that have toyed with the idea in the past, but with all the new features that have been added in the last few months, I'd love to see someone take the idea and just go full on with it. If you want to take a closer look at this, there'll be a download link below, but for now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.